Preview.
Why did Putin sit back as the United States and allies were doing strikes in Syria? Well, facing a stark choice between engaging the United States, Britain, and France in combat or just passively watching them strike his ally, Syria, Russian President Vladimir Putin opted for the peaceful route. That cautious response may have dent the Russian leader's tough man image by some of his, but it won't, his supporters, but it won't undermine his gains in Syria or erode his authority back home in Russia. Matter of fact, the Kremlin had warned Washington that Russia would fend off any strikes that jeopardized its servicemen in Syria. And the West respected that red line by giving advance notice of Saturday night's attack, just as it did a year ago when it struck a Syrian airbase. Russia had sat idly back then, but this time it had threatened to retaliate. But such a clash could have quickly spun out of control. An extremely dangerous scenario that was widely compared to the 1962 Cuban Missile Crisis when the world narrowly escaped a nuclear conflict. Matter of fact, with our allies, we ensured that the Russians were warned ahead of time, said French Defense Minister Florence Parly. And the United States-led airstrikes were a response to a purported chemical attack, allegedly on civilians in the Syrian town of Douma, which is a suburb of Damascus, back on Saturday, April the 7th. Russia said its experts found no trace of chemical agents. But a senior French official noted that President Emmanuel Macron did not tell Putin about the strike when they were speaking on the phone Friday, but certain deconfliction mechanisms had already been triggered by that point, and both knew that a new phase was going to begin quickly. Putin condemned Saturday night strikes as an act of aggression that would worsen the humanitarian catastrophe in Syria and have a destructive influence on the entire system of international relations. He criticized Washington and its allies for attacking without waiting for the inspectors from the International Chemical Weapons Watchdog Group to visit Douma, just outside of Damascus. The Russian military said its air defenses at two bases in Syria tracked the incoming missiles but didn't engage them. Russia's social media was buzzing Saturday night with angry Russian nationalists blasting Putin for failing to protect his ally. But state TV focused on criticizing the West for acting on the basis of what Moscow called a fake chemical attack. Now, it's funny that Putin was being blasted by his own allies, his own followers, some of his own supporters in Russia for not retaliating, and Trump was being blasted by some of his own allies and supporters for going forward with the precise chemical weapon facilities, research centers. No civilians were killed in this attack. It wasn't like Trump just indiscriminately fired missiles into the Damascus population. He precisely took out just the areas that could manufacture or store chemical weapons. He did what he said he would do. And he has already said he's getting out of Syria, which is exactly what he said he would do. He said if there was ever chemical weapons used, that's a red line, he would destroy their capabilities to produce them. And remember, Putin had signed an agreement with Syria promising Obama that he would get all chemical weapons out of Syria. And obviously that didn't happen. Now, whether Assad used those chemicals on his people or was this another faction, could it have been ISIS? Could it have been the Free Syrian Army? Could it have been someone else? Of course, there's so many rogue radicals roaming around. So that's another reason to blow up the facilities so that no more of it can be produced, at least not for some time. Now, the Kremlin's tight control over the media in Russia will help Putin avoid any significant damage to his carefully nurtured image of a strong leader. In fact, his cautious stance could boost his popularity further amid the fears of war that swept Russia. In recent days, state media have been offering tips on how to behave in a nuclear conflict, and even Russia had told citizens to prepare for World War III. Now, most Russians will now heave a sigh of relief and feel grateful to Putin for pulling back from the brink of war. And really, people in America should praise Donald Trump, not turn on Donald Trump, but praise him for taking out the chemical weapons capabilities without engaging with Russia or creating World War III. Now, somebody did, though, fly in there and blow up that Iranian airbase in Aleppo. And reports, I have 17 different news agencies, says it was the Israelis, including Breitbart News, including I-24 out of France, including the Times of Israel, and including Al Jazeera and Al Arabiya, and several news agencies out of the Europe. Yet the United States mass media refused to even mention that it was attacked. They won't even mention that there was explosions. Even Turkey, CNN Turkey announced that there were explosions and that the Turkish government thought it was probably Israel. And even Russia admits that the Iranian airbase exploded and said, but we don't know who did it. It's an unidentified fighter jets. Folks, Israel's not going to tell you if they did it or not. When they flew into Syria in 2007 and blew up the Syrian nuclear facilities, they never admitted they did it until this year. They took 11 years and finally said, oh, by the way, yeah, we did do that in 2007. So as this thing intensifies, we may be going to see a cooling off now, and Trump will win big by getting the U.S. troops out of Syria and yet still protecting Israel, while Putin wins big by getting to keep Syria under his thumb and his puppet leader of Assad, Bashar al-Assad. Let's hope that the people of Syria can win. No more war, no more beheadings, no more massacring, no more gas attacks, no more hatred, no more crucifixions, no more executions, no more murders and rapes. Yeah.